today we are hearing about Mahaprakash, one of the pastimes, and the Lila of in Gaur Lila, about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Lila, and wonderful pastimes where he reveals his identity to the chosen devotees. So Srila Narottam Das Thakur says, Gaurangera Madhya Lila Jara Karane Pravashila Rudayo Nirmala Belathar. Means, if anybody gives submission, oral reception to pleasing and sweet pastimes of Lord Chaitanya, then immediately his heart becomes cleansed of all material contaminations. Jay Gauranga Namaloy Tarahoy Premadoy Tare Moy Joy Boli Hari. Anyone who simply chants the name of Krishna, Chaitanya, will immediately develop love of God. I'll offer him all congratulations. Who is saying this? Narottam Das Thakur. He's saying, I'll offer him all congratulations. Why? Because you are chanting and hearing the names of Lord Chaitanya. So, we are all hearing about Mahaprakash Lila. Lord Chaitanya comes to Shiva's house and manifests what he calls as Mahaprakash in the house of Shiva's. When Lord Chaitanya comes, he reveals his identity to the chosen devotees all, because nobody is other than intimate devotees of Lord Chaitanya is allowed inside the Shiva's house. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, one time, what are we doing at the night? We are wasting time in sleeping. We'll chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. We'll do kirtan all the night. Now all the devotees there says, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, let's chant Hare Krishna. Let's do kirtan. So outside Srivasa's house, there are many devotees waiting to enter into the Srivasa's house. But they were not let inside. They were envious and proud. They were rebellious because they were hurt. So they were spreading all types of nasty rumors about Srivas and his associates. And they were talking to themselves. Every night they used to come to the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya, Lord Shiva Sangan, and they were spreading the rumors. See this, Lord, I don't know. They say, Sayas, we know why they not let us inside this house. Because they were all doing the nasty things in this house. They all chant tantric mantras during the day. And they'll all make the girls to come in the night and they lock the doors. This Srivas is criminal and his associates are criminals. And they're doing all abominable activities. They were offending this Chaitanya's associates and Shivas. So one of them told, so we have to stop this, because in Navadvip there are many scholars, many acharyas, many scholarly person, they are in good standing. What is this Lord, what is this Shivas he's doing? He's just chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra and just shouting and screaming kirtan doing all the night. But see, we are all very pious person. We are all enlightened persons here. But this, they say that Lord Krishna is in the heart of everyone as a Paramatma. So they, why do they want to scream all the night? Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. The Lord cannot hear. They're offending. They're offending Krishna. By offending, in Navadvip, they get all the tragedies, famine, and all types of natural calamities. So they thought to themselves, we should stop it. We should stop this nonsense, he says. Then they say, one of them say, yes, we have to report to the king. And they, we should take them into jail, put them into jail, beat them up. Says another person says, no, no, we don't have time for that. We have to just demolish the house of Shivas and put them into the Ganga and beat them up and lock them up, you should say. So they are screaming and shouting and everything is happening outside Srivasa's house. And one of the pious persons comes outside and say, they are very fortunate. They are hearing the Leela of Gaurasundara and they are chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. They are doing Kirtan all the night. So they are so fortunate. They are so fortunate. Because I did not get into the house because of my past credits, which is not there with me. They are so fortunate. They thought, he is the one of the person. Beat him up, they said. So they beat him up and by the like this, they used to shouting at in Shrivas, near the Srivasa's place. But inside the house, these devotees, they were not knowing anything outside, what is happening outside. Why? Because they were intensely doing kirtan and focusing on Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Leela. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So one day, on this particular day, generally in the previous, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is come as a devotee. He never shows anybody is a original form. But on this particular day, this day of Mahaprakash Leela, he went into Srivas' courtyard and sat on the Vishnu's throne. Sometimes he would do this for the pleasure of the devotees. But on this day, and very convincingly, he sits on the throne of Vishnu and takes the shalibram and shows, I am Krishna myself. He says, everybody has said, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. So they were all very happy to see the form of the Krishna. So then, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, arrange for my Abhishek. So Gaur Purnima is coming and we can all see Lord's Abhishek, how we are doing. So at that time, it is the first time in the history that personally they are doing Abhishek of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So how fortunate they are. They are all very simple and nice devotees. So Shiva says, make the arrangements, elaborate arrangements of Abhishek and everything. They all get the ingredients, everything. And they chant Purusha Shuktas, sing the Hare Krishna Mahamantra and everything. So all the devotees, like main Srivas, Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita, they were all doing Abhishek and pouring the pots and pots water on Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's head. So some devotees, like some maidservants, they used to go and get the water from Ganga. And one of the devotees, her name is Dukhi. One girl by name Dukhi. She comes and her service is just getting some Ganga water, putting the pots in the row. Just like when we do Abhishekam, we all make arrangements of the pots and everything, milk and everything they do. So like that, Dukhi's service is just like that. Just take the water from Ganga, make the arrangements pot in a row nicely. And she was doing this with utmost sincerity, utmost love to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And she was watching Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And at the background, nobody was seeing Dukhi. Because this is the first time in the history happening, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Abhishek was happening. And Lord Chaitanya and everybody was there, everybody, all great devotees are watching Lord Chaitanya. And nobody was watching Gauranga Prabhu, Gauranga Mahaprabhu. But Lord Gauranga is watching Dukhi. And he asked, Shivas, who is this? Who is this girl? And Shivas replied, this girl, simple girl, maid servant, her name is Dukhi. So why her name is Dukhi? In the at that time in Bengal, there was a sentiment that some mothers, they have many child. At the time of birth, or sometimes after the birth, young children die. So like this, many children come. Sometimes one child survives. So because they see that Yamaraj will have some mercy on the child, so they'll not check. So they'll name the children as Dukhi. Means miserable, very miserable. So he has some compassionate Yamaraj. So that sentiment was there. So they name as Dukhi. So generally, whose parents will name the child miserable one? Dukhi. So this was the sentiment. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked, something in my heart she was. I'm not feeling right. Her name is Dukhi. On this day, I will give her name as Sukhi. So everybody say, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. All the devotees were very happy there, chanting Hare Krishna, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. And this Dukhi is a simple maid servant. She got, along with the name Sukhi, all the happiness she got, eternal happiness, what she was looking for, the perfection of life. And she got also, along with the name, she got also Krishna Prema. What the gnanis, what the yogis which did not get, she got a simple Dukhi, a maid servant doing a simple thing, she got the name, she got the eternal happiness, eternal Krishna Prema, eternal bhakti for Lord Gauranga. What we understand by this? She, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never sees, or Krishna never sees the external thing of a devotee, or external, whether you're rich or you're poor or what you have, you know, eloquent speaking or doing kirtan, everything. No. It was a simple thing. She doesn't have wealth, anything. But not only seva, simple seva. She's not even coming out and just arranging the pots so that the easy for the devotees to carry the pot and do the abhishek. That she was doing with utmost sincerity. So that attracted the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. That attracted the mercy of the Lord Chaitanya. So like this, Sukhi was very happy and she was overwhelmed and she was jumping in joy because she was getting so much of happiness in the heart. So like this, you know, even we can understand, you know, when we come to the temple, some simple service, you know, we should not expect anything, but something sometimes, like myself, when I do some service, I'll expect some, you know, glorification or something like that. But this devotee, they did not expect any glorification. But just to please, simply please the Lord Gauranga, she was doing this simple service. So she was attracted by Lord Chaitanya. So this is how Mahaprakash Lila started. And now he turns to Srivas and he asks Srivas, do you remember when you were going to the school of Devananda Pandit? So you were hearing the lectures of Srimad Bhagavatam and you were in ecstasy crying, hearing the lectures of Srimad Bhagavatam. And all the students there thought, oh, this Srivas is a little bit now overly doing it. He was listening. So it was disturbance for them in the class. Now sometimes in our class also, sometimes somebody says, oh, Haribol, Haribol. And we thought, oh, this fellow is simply acting. Throw him out. So that cannot happen because we don't have love of Krishna like Srivas. So Srivas, he was really literally crying for after hearing Srimad Bhagavatam lectures. So all the students there, they thought, one warning, two warnings, three warnings they gave. And they finally, they took Srivas out and put him on the ground. And Srivas fell unconscious there. And after externally coming to the conscious, Srivas saw he was in the ground and he was very sad. And that time, again, he went to the house to read Srimad Bhagavatam to get the taste of Krishna Prema. So how many of us are like myself? So we go home, oh, we're not getting Krishna Prema, we have to read Srimad Bhagavatam lecture and now we have to release ourselves. But when he read the lectures of Srimad Bhagavatam, tears would flow in his eyes. And he was in ecstasy crying for Krishna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, that bhava, that prema, I gave it for you. I was the one who gave for you. Because I could not see the sorrow in you. Then Srivas was very happy and he was very overwhelmed in the heart. So like this, one by one, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu called and he was calling all the devotees and exhibiting his Leela there. Then he calls Gangadas. Gangadas, you remember when at that time when Navadvip there was a king, there was a persecuted, they will all persecute the people of Navadvip. Like today you can see here CAA. So what is all going in day-to-day life? At that time only, they were the Muslims king used to do this. So the Muslim king, they were sending the dacoits. No, and Murari Gupta, his wife, his daughter, they were running for the life. They ran and ran and ran and ran. At that time they ran, suddenly they saw it was a midnight. And they, again, they can't go forward because Ganga was there. It was flowing in a full, strong current. And it was a huge. And Gangadas Pandit, he did not know what to do. And he thought, because the dacoits was coming nearer and nearer, he was shivering. And he thought, instead of they molest our children or my wife, better give up the life in Ganga. Sometimes it happened. I was thinking how it happened. Sometimes in last previous year, I was in Navdeep Dham in Mayapur. So I went for a shopping, I and another devotee. So I did not know, it was already late. So the last boat was 6:30. So while shopping, we thought, I did not notice the time. And somebody, by chance, they told, the last boat is 6:30 for to go to Mayapur. We were in Navdeep. So at that time, at the last boat, I thought many people will come because there is no boat at all after that. So we were thinking how to go about. Somehow we got into the boat and got to the Mayapur. So like this, in the middle of the night, which boat is available? Which boatman is available there? So Gangadas was very much afraid. And suddenly, at the darkness in the night, a boatman appeared. And boatman appeared. Gangadas very happy. Please take me, I'll give whatever you want. Please make me to cross the Ganga. So that boatman will take Gangadas and his family there. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, that boatman is myself. I came from my abode just to protect you. And Gangadas Pandit was very, very, again, he was also very happy. And he showed his form to even Gangadas Pandit. Then he calls Kolavicha Sridhar. Means his name is Sridhar. He says devotees there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that, bring Kolavicha Sridhar. And nobody knew who was Sridhar there. And everybody asking, who is Sridhar? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Kolavicha Sridhar is a very simple banana seller. He'll be in the edge of, in Srimantadeep, edge of the town, he'll be sitting and chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. You can just go, follow his voice and you'll find him. So all the devotees ran there and went to Navdeep, and for sure they found him very humbly crying for Krishna's name, Haribol, Haribol, and chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra there. And then they asked Sridhar, Shri, Lord Gauranga is calling you. By this time, Kolavicha Sridhar came to know who is Lord Gauranga. And he said, Gauranga is calling me? I'm a simple banana seller. Why is Gauranga calling me? No, it can't be. And he fell unconscious on the ground. What is Kolavicha? His name is Sridhar. But nobody bothered him to call on the name of Sridhar. Kolavicha means, it's just a banana seller. So this banana seller was very, very humble, very humility. He was crying all the night. And by the time when he opens his house, and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, get up, Kolavicha. Now I'll show my form as Shama Sundar. And he shows his form as a Shama Sundar. And he was a beautiful Shama Sundar, you can see. And next to him was Balaram. So, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explains, you remember Kolavicha Sridhar? At the time, he was a young boy. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a young boy as Nimai Pandit. So Nimai Pandit was coming every day to Navdeep in Srimantadeep, where this Kolavicha was selling the banana products. He was selling banana leaf and banana flower and banana products, basically. Then he remembers, he recounts the pastime of Kolavicha. And every time, Nimai would give him a very hard time to Kolavicha Sridhar. At least every day he argues with Kolavicha 2 hours in bargaining the banana. And Kolavicha Sridhar, he was very, very, very low priced. He will say, no, bottom rock price in the entire market of Navadvip. So, and he, Sridhar was very, very compassionate and very, you know, in his, even his business also, he wanted to give the least possible price for banana. And everybody in Navadvip was going to this Kolavicha. Why? Because he was giving no arguments there. But Nimai Pandit, he was arguing, Kolavicha, I will take your banana. What is this rate? He said, 12 cowries, he said. Cowries means some, that was the currency, medium of currency at that time in Navadvip. So, Mahaprabhu says, Nimai Pandit says, 12 cowries, I give only 6. You are cheating, he says. He says, my price, you know, everybody knows in Navadvip, my price is the lowest. No, no, you are cheating. I'm a Brahmana. You should not cheat me. Then, like this, the argument goes and goes and goes, goes on and on and on. Then again, he takes the banana and gives half the price. And finally, he leaves there. Then all the next businessman, he was saying, why do you argue with me? Why do you give bananas? I don't know, something in my heart. I feel so much ecstasy in my heart. So even it is in low price, I don't bother. I just give bananas because I'm feeling some love in my heart. So because he never knew Nimai Pandit was Lord Krishna himself or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. But he was somehow in the heart, he was feeling so much of ecstasy. Just like in Krishna Lila, now all the gopas and gopis was in a Brahma Vimochan Lila. They were serving all the cows and all the gopas, gopis and all, even though they are not this one, but there was so much of love in the heart of the mothers. So like this, even Kolavicha Sridhar also was finding so much love for Nimai Pandit, and he used to give the bananas to this one, Nimai Pandit. So Nimai Pandit, like this, he was spending every day 2 hours, even though he was giving very hard time. Sridhara was, what is this, one more thing about Sridhara was, Kolavicha was, he was bringing this banana because in this Navadvip, everybody was growing bananas. So, there is a saying that in the new castle, you are like just selling the coal. Means, in the coal mines, if you go and sell the coal, it is not very lucrative business, right? It is not very good business. It will get very simply this one. Similarly, in Navadvip also, everybody was growing banana and Sridhar was getting this banana and selling, which is not a good business at all. But still, with utmost sincerity, with utmost this one, he was selling bananas, out of which first half, which is get the profit of it, was he was doing the devotional service by doing Ganga Puja. So even he was very, very small business. And that too, Nimai was bargaining. In that too also, 50% he was spending in the on Ganga Puja. So, Kolavicha Sridhar was like this, very humble, and he attracted the mercy of the Lord. So we can learn from Kolavicha Sridhar, even though he's a simple banana seller, but still he got mercy of the Lord. And also, what is this Kolavicha Sridhar? By social perspective, he was very poor. And all the neighbors will come and give the advice to Kolavicha Sridhar. Oh, Kolavicha Sridhar, why don't you stop Ganga Puja for 1 year? You can build up some capital and you can do bigger Ganga Puja. And he said, if Krishna wants to make me rich, I'll be rich. But I don't know if I will do the Ganga Puja every day. I may not do. So whatever I have, I'm happy with it, he says. And they said, Kolavicha Sridhar, you don't have even a dhoti to wear. Your dhoti is all torn, and all he was put the knot, and 2,000 knots was there in the dhoti. And they were saying, and Kolavicha Sridhar says, at least I'm not naked. And the Kolavicha, people there are saying, you don't have any house, you have a straw hut, and even that straw hut, you have many holes. He says, at least I have a roof on my top. And he says, at least I have a roof on my top, sometimes the sunshine comes. Oh, Kolavicha Sridhar, if you will not take any good advice, you are very poor. And everybody is saying, he is like that. And they would go. And after some time, He, Kolavicha Sridhar, chants full 12 hours a night, chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, the Mahamantra. And all the neighbors was disturbed. This Kolavicha Sridhar, sometimes they would throw the vegetable, take it, eat this and shut up. Because he was disturbing all the neighbors. So like that, Kolavicha Sridhar's pastime was so much, you know, loving pastimes was there. And after that, he was chanting the mantra whole night, whole this one. And they were thinking, this Kolavicha Sridhar is very poor. Not because of love he is chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Not because of that. Because he is very poor. Because he don't have anything to eat. So he is howling and chanting. That's all. And they were shouting at them. So like this, this Kolavicha Sridhar was a very simple, humble, and what he got is that he has got no wealth. He has got he's not wealthy, and he was a still simple banana seller, and he was doing a simple service, just giving some bananas to Nimai Pandit. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked, so I am very pleased, my Lord, you can glorify me. He said, my Lord, I am not educated, I am not very learned, so I can't glorify you, that you are a supreme personality of Godhead. How can I glorify you? And it's okay. Tell anything. Whatever comes from your mouth, it will become a prayer. So then, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu blesses him, and Mother Saraswati sits on the tongue, and he glorifies Lord Chaitanya. And then Mahaprabhu was very much pleased. And he says, Sridhar, please ask some benediction. I'll give you benediction, whatever you want. Please ask. Said, my Lord, I'm very much pleased. I'm very much satisfied. I don't want anything. Sridhara, you should ask something. Please ask. Please ask, he says. But then he says, I will give you 8 mystic powers, which everyone in this material world can live long. So in every time he asks, and Sridhara says, rejected. And Sridhara says, my Lord, be peaceful. Who is saying? Sridhara is saying for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. My Lord, be peaceful. I said, Mahaprabhu says, no, I am peaceful. You should ask something. I will give you benediction. I will give you liberation. Get rid from birth, old age, death and disease. My Lord, I don't even want that. Sridhara, for the pleasure of me, you should ask something. Then, if at all you want, I want to ask, I want one thing, my Lord. I want to be the servant of the servant of the servant and serve you. Even though by chance I'd not be your, at least I should born in a family of a devotee to serve you, because I'm not qualified to be in your Leela. Then he asked, and at least you come as a Nimai Pandit and snatch by bananas, and that will please, that's what I want, he says. So that's, now all the devotees there says Haribol, Haribol. They chanted Haribol, and Sridhara was also so much happy. So by this we should know. So even it is said in Chaitanya Bhagavat, there was an equal caliber of Sridhara, who Pratapa Rudra, Buddhimanta Khan, and sometimes Ramananda Rai also was there. So why only Kolavicha Sridhar got the mercy? Because they were all Prataparudra was very rich. It is not the disqualification if you have the wealth, but it is not the qualification or disqualification for having the bhakti. But Kolavicha Sridhar did not have anything, but he still was qualified to have the mercy of the Lord. That's what it shows here in Mahaprakash Lila. So then he sees Mukunda. Say, Mukunda, do you remember? No, sorry. He says, Murari Gupta. And he says, Murari. Not Murari Prabhu. Then he's called Murari. He said, do you remember when at the time when he was getting the Sanjeevani for Lord Lakshman? And when he came to the Lanka, you burned whole city of Lanka with your tail because of the love for Lord Ram. You see he sees the form of Sri Ram and Sita Lakshman, and he shows, and he says, and at the time, Murari Gupta was, suddenly he sees back, and he sees the tail. And his body was like a monkey, and he was Hanuman. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu revealed what he was. You are Hanuman. And Murari Gupta, by profession, he was a simple doctor, Ayurvedic doctor in Navadvip. So, for the love of the God, it was simply he got the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And then he sees Haridas Thakur. Haridas, do you remember when you was hit in 21 marketplaces? You were, but I wanted to sever the head of all the demons there in Navadvip there, because they were beating you in 21 marketplaces. Generally, it says that 3 lashings, if you hit, the person will die. But Haridas Thakur was taken a beating for 21 times in the marketplace. Then he was chanting the mantras, and he was asking for the Lord, please forgive them, because they were inflicting pain on me. Don't, please give the mercy to them. So he was praying, so that because of your prayers, I could not do anything. That's why I did not sever the heads. But I did not have any other options, but just to give my body for that lashings. Then he opened the chadar and sees the lashing behind the Mahaprabhu's back. There was so much lashing. And Haridas saw, and many other devotees saw the lashing, and they were just, how can I inflict the pain on you, Mahaprabhu? And he was crying. Haridas chose. And he says, because you are chanting my holy name, and you are very simple, even though you are born in the family of a Muslim family, you are a Mlecha, but he never says Mlecha, but even though he was born in a Muslim family also, but because of the love and chanting the mantra with a sincere, so he got the mercy of the Lord. So like this, Haridas Thakur also got the mercy of the Lord, and he says, your body is like me, better than my body. Say, how that Lord is respecting? He is just a Mlecha. But every says, but he made him a Namacharya. So like this, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was exhibiting one by one the Leela. So like that. And finally, he asked the Mukunda. He says, somebody came, Srivas came to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. My Lord, you gave mercy to everyone. You gave mercy to everyone here, but you forgot your devotee, Mukunda. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, no, I don't want to see this Mukunda. I don't want even to see his face, says. And Mukunda asks Srivas, at least sometime will I be able to, ever be able to see, get the darshan of Lord Chaitanya? And Chaitanya, and again Srivas goes there. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, no, I will not give you mercy. I will not give you my darshan. Initially he says that because he was stabbing me from behind. Literally he was not stabbing. That means he was singing nicely with us, chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra and everything. But he was going to the Mayavadis and singing with them also. It is like a stabbing me from behind. So we should understand, when we take up the Krishna consciousness, a Krishna consciousness is the ultimate goal of life. And when we see some Mayavadis or something, somebody outside of our Krishna consciousness, we should not go and join. Of course, we should respect them, but we should not go and join them and sing other mantras or something like that. So this Ganga, this Mukunda is showing that. And finally, the last time he asked, my dear Lord, he asked Srivas that at least please ask, he will give me the darshan. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, after 10 million births, I will see him. And Mukunda hears that, and he will be jumping with joy. My Lord, I am so happy. I'm getting the darshan of the Lord. Even after 10 million births, he was jumping and jumping. Even after 10 million births, he was ready to wait for the mercy of the Lord. Not for this lifetime, not for the next lifetime, but 10 million births, he was ready to wait for the mercy of the Lord and just to have a darshan of the Lord. He was waiting for 10 million births. That means he has got so much love for Krishna, so much faith in the words of Mahaprabhu, that at least I will get the darshan. Sure enough, you'll get the darshan. So he was happy. because of such a unflinching faith he had on Mahaprabhu's words, immediately Mahaprabhu came and embraced him. Because you had so much faith, I will give a darshan. Not only gave the darshan, but he embraced him and he gave the mercy. And all the, you can see this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Mahaprakash Lila. What is this followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's followers are not very simple by nature. And also, they were not wealthy. They were not educated. They don't know to counter-argument. They don't know to quote shastras. Nothing. And they were not even educated. By external conscience, external also, they were not looking very good. But by the simple service to Lord Chaitanya, the faith they had in Lord Chaitanya, so that attracted the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. So many times we may think that, you know, we have our name, fame, wealth, everything, so that I'm a superior Vaishnava. So Vaishnava is not gauged by what he is quoting from shastras or from jnanas or from wealth, or if he has wealth or from riches. No, just by some small seva behind and doing with utmost sincerities will attract Lord Chaitanya. So the conclusion is this. No, we have to be simple, do service with utmost sincerity and attract the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, so that we'll also get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya and go back home, go back to Godhead. Hare Krishna.